Hello, dear viewers. Warm welcome to online English and German classes. Today we are going to study the second chapter of Flamingo, class 12. The title of the story is The Lost Spring by Anis Jung. Before I begin with the story about the author, Anis Jung was born in the year 1964 in Rourkela, Odisha. He spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. She received her education in Hyderabad and in the United States of America. Her parents were both writers. Anis Jung began her career as a writer in India. She has been an editor and columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad, and has authored several books. The following is an excerpt from the book titled Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Here, she analyzes the grinding poverty and traditions which condemn these children to a life of exploitation. Now, without wasting your and my time, I begin. Paragraph 1. Why sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage? Why do you do this? I asked Sahab, whom I encounter every morning, scrounging for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. Sahab left his home long ago, set amidst the green fields of Dhaka. His home is not even a distant memory. There were many storms that swept away their fields and homes, his mother tells him. That's why they left looking for gold in the big city where he now lives. Now, let us discuss paragraph number one. Dear readers, in paragraph number one, Sahab is a young boy, maybe 12-year-old. He is a rag picker. Okay? The boy is seeking his prospects or future or good luck in the garbage. It can be both a hyperbole and an irony to build one's future from the dump of garbage, from the lump of garbage, from the dump of garbage. Second, we come to know in paragraph number one that he hails from Bangladesh. So, dear readers, Bangladesh witnesses storms, cyclones, floods. You know, lakhs of peoples are displaced or rendered homeless because of these natural calamities. And as usual, the poor are the worst sufferers. We all know 3-1 is looking for gold in the big city. So this looking for gold in the big city has a bigger meaning, dear readers. We all fall in this category, to be frank. One way or the other, people migrate from village to city or town to bigger cities to earn more money and be gentlemen and try to look like our masters, the English. The same way, thousands of rag pickers migrate to cities because they see better opportunities, better prospects there in big cities. So there we find similarities between the rag pickers, the laborers, and we. What is the similarity? Better standard of living. In search of this, we migrate to bigger cities. Paragraph 2. I have nothing else to do, he mutters, looking away. Go to school, I say glibly, realizing immediately how hollow the advice must sound. After months of knowing him, I ask him his name, Sahab-e-Alam. He announces, he does not know what it means. If he knew it, you know, what happens? Sahab-e-Alam. Sahab-e-Alam. So, you know, this is an irony. Sahab-e-Alam means the boy answers, there is no school in my neighborhood. When they build one, I will go. The author says, if I start a school, will you come? The author says, I ask half joking. Yes, he says, smiling broadly. A few days later, I see him running up to me. Is your school ready? It takes longer to build a school. I say, embarrassed at having made a promise that was not meant, but promises like mine abound in every corner of this bleak world. Dear friends, when he says there is no school in my neighborhood, when they build one, I will go. This reflects the innocence of the rag picker, though he has been brought up in acute poverty. But still, he is morally stronger than we educated people. That poverty has not snatched innocence from this rag picker. The author says, if I start a school, will you come? I ask half joking. So like author, there are thousands of people like author and like us who makes fun of or who are very insincere or insensitive. The author, I don't mean he or she is insensitive, but we are not sincere when we talk with them. That has become the habit of the educated class of society. Yes, he says, smiling broadly. Again, in this smile, we see the innocence of that rag picker. We condemn those poor people, rag pickers, and the people of that class of society. We look down upon them, but I feel they have more innocence in them than we educated people have. That is what it shows according to the text. A few days later, I see him running up to me. Is your school ready? So this statement of the child, okay, is your school ready? So when the author says that if I build a school, will you come? So the author, see how highly educated. So like author, I don't say the author is wrong here or she is insensitive, but we educated people, how we talk, when we talk with those rag pickers or this, the poorest class of society, are we sincere? Do we talk with our children or our relatives in the same vein as we talk with them? Are we so insincere when we talk with our own people? No. So unconsciously we become insincere or we become false when we talk to these people. Okay? But here, is your school ready? It reflects once again the innocence of that rag picker. I must say that the acute poverty and the poor upbringing, I should not say poor upbringing, but upbringing in acute poverty, poor upbringing is that upbringing which makes us morally weak in spite of rich upbringing. So the upbringing is poor, but upbringing in acute poverty, I should say. Okay, so the author is embarrassed. She is ashamed. At least she has the mind to be ashamed. How many of us feel embarrassed when we be insincere or insensitive to this class of people, the deprived people, forget about the. Why aren't you wearing chappals? I asked one. Sorry, but before that it is, after months of knowing him, I ask him his name. Sahab-e-Alam, he announces. He does not know what it means. If he knew its meaning, Lord of the Universe, that means, he would have a hard time believing it. Unaware of what his name represents, he roams the streets with his friends, an army of barefoot boys who appear like the morning birds and disappear at noon. Over the months, I have come to recognize each of them. So here, Sahab-e-Alam, dear readers, what an irony. Sahab-e-Alam means Lord of the Universe. And in practical life, what is he? He is a rag picker who tries to look for his future in the garbage, in the dump of garbage. Okay, so it is an irony here. They roam from one street to the other, and there are many other boys like him. Sahab-e-Alam. Okay. Now, why aren't you wearing chappals? I asked one. My mother didn't bring them down from the shelf. He answers simply. Even if she did, he will throw them off, adds another who is wearing shoes that do not match. When I comment on it, he shuffles his feet and says nothing. I want shoes, says a third boy who has never owned a pair all his life. Traveling across the country, I have seen children walking barefoot. In cities, on village roads, it's not lack of money, but a tradition to stay barefoot is one explanation. I wonder if that can be true. Here, when the child says, my mother didn't bring them down from the shelf, dear friends, do you believe what the boy says? We don't know. You think over it. We can discuss later. Okay. Now, one among the other boys is wearing unmatching shoes. We come to know one among them is wearing unmatching shoes. There is one boy. There is another boy, one of them, informs the author that he has never owned a pair of shoes all his life. Now, dear readers, we cannot be sensitive. We are not in habit of being sensitive to others' feelings, particularly to the poorest class, to the weakest class of society. But okay, I am a bit more emotional, though I don't do much for them. Okay, so you just think about this, the contrast, the life of the people living in big cities and those who are rag pickers. So even in India, because we have two countries, one is has all kinds of one kind of children having all kinds of facilities, and they have not seen poverty in their life. And there are others who live in acute poverty. And there are many, some of them, see, in this 21st century, when we boast about becoming Vishwa Guru, and we have millions of children like them, thousands, I should say, I don't know the number, who are like these, lakhs of people, children are there who are like Sahab-e-Alam and other children, those rag pickers. So this is an irony. One way we claim to be the you know, going the other way. So there cannot be that true development with thousands of or lakhs of millions of people going empty stomach to their bed and then boasting about becoming a developed nation. Okay, so we need to, now they will they live in perpetual that permanent state of poverty? Okay, they are destined to live like that. God has written in their fate that. Or will there be will any Godfather appear to save them? While you think about these burning issues, and we will meet again in the next video. The power has also gone off. So thank you very much. God bless you all. And we will meet in the next video. Thank you.